Today, we're going to be talking about the PPSH41 stats, its most effective build, and how to use it. Quick note, this video was done, but I was quite surprised to see that the PPSH was buffed on the mid-season update. So all the information here will be accurate as of this update. The PPSH41 is a pretty unique weapon. It's not the first to try to be a more long-range SMG, but it is one of the only SMGs that has one drop-off range, treating it more like an assault rifle than an SMG. While the PPSH41 was pretty lackluster on release, I think now that it's gotten its buff, it is the best long-range SMG in the game. As always, we'll dive into its stats with all the attachments you would normally run. In this build, we're using the GRE Suppressor, the 14.9-inch Ranger Barrel to help with those engagements between 30 and 40 meters, the Raider Stock, the Spetsnaz Grip, and the 55-round Drum. If you don't think you need the extra velocity because you'll be using it at closer ranges, you can swap the Ranger Barrel for an Optic. But let's get straight into the stats. Its ADS time is absolutely amazing at 170 milliseconds. This is one of the faster aim down sights times that I have tested so far. Its reload speed is pretty average for an SMG. Its mag cap is 55, which isn't the greatest, but it does work. Although after the update, if you don't want that super snappy ADS, you can definitely use a larger mag. Its movement and sprint speed are absolutely great, and its ADS stray speed is pretty average for an SMG. Its sprint out time and tactical sprint out time are absolutely great. Its stability is actually really great for an SMG. Its velocity though is not that great at 625 meters per second. Although at 625 meters per second, you won't have to lead your target all the way up to 60 meters. And its rate of fire is absolutely amazing at 908 rounds per minute, or 15.1 rounds per second. When we add up all the mobility points, we get a score of 42. Its recoil is really great. It makes a really slight S pattern, but it's extremely easy to control. Because of how easy it is to control, it gets a recoil score of 37. Its damage is pretty unique. It acts a little more like an assault rifle than a SMG. It only has one drop-off range, but I included three here to show you the difference in bullet velocity. Under 18 meters, its upper and lower torso damage is so great that it can compete with the Modern Warfare MP5. Its limb damage is pretty good as well, and its headshot damage could be a little better, but you're already getting such a great time to kill, there's no reason to complain here. Before the update, its damage was really competitive up close, but it wasn't really that great, so it had to rely on its super fast ADS time in order to win those gunfights. After the damage drop-off point at 18 meters and all the way up to 33 meters, your time to kill isn't that great. But remember, most SMGs at this range won't be that accurate, so you'll have the advantage there, so just be cautious when you're fighting someone with an assault rifle. After 33 meters though, the PPSH does start to shine, and this is because of its single drop-off range, so any extra time to the TTK is all due to bullet velocity. And when we add up all the damage values, we get a total damage score of 53.12. And when we add up all the stats together, we get a final score of 132.12, which is really great for an SMG. So what's the best way to use this build? Well, I kinda already talked about that in my last Community Wednesday video, but if you didn't watch it, all you gotta do is pair it with a long range weapon, whether it's a sniper rifle, assault rifle, or an LMG. You can run around the map with this thing out, and unlike other SMGs, if you see a target that is at medium range, you can actually engage them without swapping to your other weapon. And of course, if you're sniping and someone approaches you, you can easily swap to this and take care of that problem. At this point though, you may be thinking, why not just use an assault rifle for that better medium range? Assault rifles that are good at close range will not be stretching out as far as the PPSH, and the assault rifles that are better at medium range will not be performing that well at close range. So, I think this is probably the best fit. As an aggressive player, with a sniper rifle and a PPSH, you can easily push players and get them down before you even enter their MP5 range. And even if you end up in a super close quarters engagement, well, your time to kill will still remain competitive. And for defensive players, if you're sniping and you start getting rushed or you get ambushed when trying to get to your next location, the PPSH should be able to take care of any situation. So the PPSH is a pretty versatile gun, and I highly recommend it for basically any playstyle. Which kind of worries me a little, because it was in a great spot before as a long-range SMG that was still competitive up close, but now it's really great up close and still pretty good at long range, so I think it's probably going to end up getting nerfed. But that's the PPSH41. What do you think about it and the role it has in Warzone? And if you used it, what do you think about it? And if you ran it before, are you considering running now? Let me know in the comments. And remember, if you got any questions, topics, or ideas you want me to cover, leave them down here or on Instagram. and you may see them on the next Community Wednesday. But that's the video. If you enjoyed our first help video in any way, please hit like. If you got any questions or comments, leave them down in the comments section down below. And if you want to make sure that you never miss another video, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.